Hello, my friends. How are you doing today? We're just going to do a quick shot of the Road to the Roses update today. Nothing fancy, but I'm going to show you where we stand and where we're going. Stage two begins this weekend, so you don't want to miss out. You want to create your stable and get something going so you can possibly win stage two. There's some nice prizes available for that. And of course, you could attempt to win a weekly prize as well. So let's get right on to it. Get on to what happened so far. Well, here's what happened before the contest started. The area I've highlighted there, those are the horses that won the Kentucky Derby prep races in various areas. Then the contest started on the 25th of February with the Risen Star, which was at the fairgrounds, and El Padrino ran that. The horses that I highlighted in bold there, that's for your benefit to show you the horses that were in my stable. So you can see I did get a few good wins there. I got some grade two and one grade three win, but mostly the grade twos, which you get more points for, which is good, along with a couple trainer and jockey wins. And I explained that in the last episode of the Road to the Roses last month when the stage one began. So what happened was I did kind of ignore this race. I ignored the Battaglia altogether because I didn't even know who was going to be in it. And in the Tampa Bay and the Swell, I'll show you in a minute, I did have contenders picked for that. They did not run in the races. One of them got injured. The other one, we don't know where he's going to run next. So after all of that, scroll down to the standings here. My points 150. The leader has 188. There were many more possible. There were probably at least 300 points possible. But, you know, there's a lot of choices to make in this contest. So I got 80% of the points that the leader had. Overall rank around 2%, 500 out of 22,000. Florida rank, you don't get any prizes for the Florida League or the men's league. I think it's just for bragging rights or whatever. But so that's kind of where I stand. It's really right where I want to be right now. I didn't really necessarily want to. I did want to win stage one, but I didn't want to sell out for stage one. I wanted to have horses in my stable already to go for stage two as well. And you know, so I'm steadily progressing up every week, and it's doing pretty well. Now let's look at the schedule. As I said, here's what happened beforehand, and these were the horses that I selected for these particular races. And there were many other races. You see, I had three in my stable for each of these two, Sanfilippo and Rebel, but only three of them ran total out of the six total that I had for those two races. And these two didn't run. Take Charge Inny is skipped and is supposed to appear in the Florida Derby. Thunder Moxen, I don't know where he's going to end up yet. I'm thinking maybe the Bay Shore. So if we go down to the actual contenders here that we're looking at for the upcoming races, remember the grade three races don't count as much. The listed stake doesn't count for barely anything, but the grade one you get the most points for. So you want to focus on getting the right contenders for that, and a lot of them are the contenders that are in my stable already, and I've highlighted most of those in bold. The ones that I highlighted here for the first three races, since I'm not really confident that this is going to be real important to get anybody in these races, but if you want to pick up a win for these couple races this weekend, you know, these are the contenders. It's just too many to choose from, in my opinion. I think Castaway will be the favorite there, but Stirred Up has the top late pace. Handsome Mike has the top early pace in this one. With Well Went something was the Well Went the Day, I think his name is, has the top late pace. So there's a lot of contenders to choose from, and I wouldn't want to get bogged down in getting all these contenders because you only have 15 plus the supplemental pick starting this week. You get 18 total roster spots. So I will probably, and of course in my first stable, I already have 15. And I can add three this week if I want to. I might add one or two of these. I'm not sure, just to try to keep the contest going. Try to pick up some points this, you know, this weekend. But if in a secondary stable I might create, I would definitely have a couple of these. So if you're starting this week, you definitely want to get you know, a couple or three of these horses that I mentioned here. And these are the horses, some of which are in my stable, and other ones that are emboldened probably will be in my stable. Consider them; they might be must-haves. El Padrino, Union Rags, Take Charge Indy, Discreet Dancer. I mean, the Louisiana Derby's looking really weak. Discreet Dancer, Mark Valesky. I don't think AlphaGo, now that Hansen has declared that he's going in the bluegrass, Alpha's going to come back probably and run in the wood because again, this race a little bit weak. And the Santa Anita Derby, Creative Cause, I'll have another Midnight Transfer. Those are all in my stable. I think you have to probably have at least two of those. You want to have definitely Creative Cause and one of these other two. And as I said, and we have no idea who's going to run in Illinois, and it's probably going to be somewhat, it's usually a fairly inconsequential race. Now, as I said, Thunder Moccasin, really strong. Trinnenberg, both of those might run in the Bay Shore. You have to have Hansen for the Bluegrass, and then Secret Circle, probably Optimizer. Almost caught Secret Circle going 8.5 furlongs last time in the Rebel, as shown above here. So I think Optimizer maybe can catch him over the course of 9 furlongs. You might want to get two of those as well. So that's what I would. And then the supplemental ends there. As you can see, there's like 30 contenders or more in all these races. I mean, what I would consider serious contenders to win them. And you have 15 plus 3, 18 roster spots. So that's about all I have today. After that, we have no idea who's running in those, and really not sure who's running in the Kentucky Derby. That field won't be finalized for quite a while. A lot of these horses get injured and so forth along the way. So that's all I have for today, folks. I hope that you have good luck in the Road to the Roses contest, and we'll give you another update as soon as possible. Talk to you later, folks.